Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another YouTube video. I'm just going to take you through a little bit of what I do before I head to the gym on days where I kind of got nothing to do. So one of the first things we're going to have to do is cook, because I don't like lifting on an empty stomach. Sometimes I do it, and the pump's crazy because you're like lean and like whatever, you know. But we're going to go with two potatoes. We're going to peel them up. We're going to fry them. These are what I call potato wheels. It's just kind of like something I was raised on when I was little. My grandpa would make rounds and rounds of these, so it's no wonder why I had a little extra weight on me when I was little. I'd eat like 7 potatoes. I don't know how, because now I'm like force feeding myself as a 20-year-old, so that's great.
I also don't like want to hear anything about the PJs. Like, what's wrong with the Cookie Monster? I mean, it's soft. Like, I don't be hating on my PJs. That's all. All right, back to the video.
All right, so one of the first things you're gonna want is some sort of oil to cook it with. So I like olive oil, extra virgin, the way I like it, and that's typically what I go with. You can do canola oil. It doesn't taste as good. Believe it or not, it does kind of absorb into the potato. So choose an oil you do like, just that way it avoids getting stuck to the pan. So going with this. So obviously I've got my morning coffee to go with me as well. I checked my morning weight and I think it said I'm like 168 waking up, which is nuts. Like, I haven't been that much since last year. But you know what? Let's go check. All right, yeah. So like 168. And like, to be fair, the clothes I'm wearing is like pretty thin. Like, these are very thin pajamas, so there's no way it weighs more than like a pound at most. So, I mean, you know, give or take 168. So I'll take that. That's pretty good. All I've had was like half a bagel and a little yogurt so far. So let's get on with the cooking. All right, so now it's time to peel the potato. I prefer to do this style of potato skinless, just because, I don't know, I just don't think it's really necessary, especially because like the shape is going to be like a circle because I'm cutting it kind of like bread, you know what I mean? So there's really no need to have the skin, so, and that's all preference. So you could probably leave the skin on if you want, that's up to you. I ain't going to say nothing, like, I mean, it'd be kind of weird if you did because you're following the recipe, but I'm not going to say anything. I like mine skinless, and this is probably the worst potato peeler I've ever used. I'm going to probably go get a new one. But yeah, I also don't know if you can tell by my voice. Guess who somehow still doesn't sound normal? Like, dude, I swear to God, my immune system is non-existent. The second I walk outside, I breathe cold air, and somehow my body thinks I have a cold. It makes no sense. Other than that, like, my nose is a little stuffy, and yes, that's my only symptom, so I'm good. I don't have anything. But it's just annoying because I feel like my freaking sinuses are just all screwed up. So now we're on to potato number 2. I'll probably just do 2 potatoes just because these are kind of smaller. I mean, actually, they're pretty big. These are pretty big potatoes, honestly. The only problem with potatoes is that it is a fairly clean carb. And so each one of these potatoes is probably like 150 to 230 calories at most. So really not getting that many calories from this. And it is really filling. So that's the only problem. So if you are looking for like a clean meal to have on your bulk, then go for this one. So as you got your 2 potatoes, we're gonna wanna rinse them off just to get off any like extra starch or any dirtiness from the skin. I don't know if you guys can see, but
that's got like a little bit of stuff in it. I don't know. Also, my nail. I don't know if I told this story, but I wanna say it was like right when school started. So around September, like early September. This was right after I got my second wave of mono, I think. So I was like finally back into lifting. And I was going for some incline dumbbell press reps, some like heavy reps. And I think I was doing 80s. And I had them on my knees, like both dumbbells, but my keys were like in my pocket. And they were kind of skidding on my nerves. So I was like, dude, come on. Right? So I got the weight still on my knees. I'm like, oh my God, what do I do? Right? And again, like the story's kind of broken because I don't really remember how it happened step by step, but it's along these lines. So I basically thought it'd be a good idea to take the dumbbell resting on my left knee, lean it up against the one on my right knee. So like, I'm holding the right dumbbell, this one leans up against it. And I thought it'd be a good idea to try to get my keys out of my pocket while I got 280-pound dumbbells on my legs. And somehow in the midst of all that, my finger, this one, got stuck in between the 280-pound dumbbells, and like my instant reaction was to like yank it out, right? First, the impact hurt like a motherfucker. Like that shit, oh dude, I wanted to scream. Like, you know what I'm saying? The worst part, like, so like not only
I love that so much, just cameras and different.
did it hurt from the impact, but then, on top of it all, I yanked my thumb out. And these were rubber dumbbells, so they were some sort of, like, grip. Shit turned black immediately, bleeding. It was just, oh, dude, and it's barely growing back in now. Moral of the story, don't fuck around with dumbbells. Don't. It's not worth it. It hurts. This shit kept me up all night for, like, 3 days straight just from, like, throbbing. I could feel the throbbing on my thumb in my head. Miserable. Don't do it. All right, now, back to the potato washing. All right, let's get to the washing. But before I get into that, if you guys do like this style of video, you can let me know by dropping a like, subscribing, and commenting that you like the style. Otherwise, you know, I won't be doing this more regularly. It just depends on how y'all like it. So if y'all like it, I like it, then great, cool. Let's get into the potato washing. So I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but it does look a lot cleaner. So that is the reason behind it. And you don't have to do anything crazy, just a few, you know what I'm saying? Just a few seconds, just a few of these. You know what I mean? It shouldn't be a chore, all right? If y'all can do rice, then y'all can do potatoes. It's so much easier. Something I like to do is I like to take a paper towel after the fact and just kind of dry it a little bit. And you might be asking,
why are you wasting a paper towel?
Well, because I'm not trying to use the hand towel that my nasty hands have been on and then transfer that bacteria to this. Call me a biologist, but I ain't doing it. It's not happening. Now we got the clean potatoes. We need to cut them, and pretty much the way I do it is I just kind of, y'all can screenshot this and use this for a meme, but no, way I like to do it is, like, just small slices, not too small, though. Like, I don't want chips, you know, because we are frying these, so keep that in mind. You don't want, like, chip-sized little slices, okay? Maybe, like, a centimeter wide. That's it. So I'm going to skip that part. I will show you the finished product of the cutting so you have an idea of what it looks like, but I just don't really feel like having knives in my YouTube videos because I am already getting banned on Instagram now. All right, so this is typically like about how thin I like them to be. Real quick though, y'all ever seen that TikTok that shows what this shit would look like from behind? Ruined the wholesomeness of this brand. I'm going to put it here for y'all. Viewer discretion advised.
What's up, guys? Albert Fingernoodle here. I farted in my grandpa's breathing machine.
All right, so now all we have left to do is to cook them. So I'm going to be using a pan about this big. Because I don't really have that many potatoes, I don't really need that big of a pan. So we're going to start with this. And what you want to do is you're going to get the pan like decently hot to the point where when the oil hits, it doesn't just sit there. It can move around. Yeah, we don't want to boil the oil or burn it, but we want the pan hot enough. So we're going to let it sit for like 30 seconds or so, let it heat up, and then we'll get back to cooking. Oh, and also, disclaimer, I'm not a sous chef or whatever they call the professional chefs. I'm not. I just cook and it works for me. So yeah, if you die from this recipe somehow, it's not on me. I'm sorry. I mean, it's potato. It's potato. How you gonna fuck that up? That's on you, all right? Just disclaimer. All right, so now it is time to put the oil. Don't do that. And you really don't need that much. I put less, but it like looks like more because it's already kind of moving around. But you really don't need that much, just enough to kind of get the whole pan lubricated. I'm sorry. And from here, we're just going to set all these potatoes down on the oil. And we're going to let it sit. And this is something that you kind of have to look over yourself, and the cooking time will vary based off of just the potato, the certain temperature of everything. So this is something that you have to kind of look after. So it will probably take around 5 to 8 minutes at most is what I typically find. I'm not going to give you guys a specific time. So you guys just watch it and cook it till they're at the point that you'd like, whether you want them crispy or whether you want them soft. So let's throw these bad boys on. So you can hear like it's kind of sizzling just a little bit, but it's not like, you know, exploding in my face. Wow, I just touched burning oil. Whew, got it. Like I said, I'm not professional. By the way, I'm in agonizing pain right now, for sure. Alright, so as it appears, I have misjudged just about how much space we would need for all these potatoes. So I've got about 5 left over. So it is what it is, not a big deal. Just cook them after dispatch. So now I'm just going to watch it, look over it. Make sure they don't burn, stuff like that. If you need to add more oil because you find... it's just not enough, you can always do that, but just do it in, like, baby doses, you know? Don't go overboard. And then also, I like to add salt and pepper just to get a more flavor, and yeah, so that's up to you as well. Whatever spices you want. And one important thing, obviously, you gotta flip them. So, do not forget to flip and make sure that every side gets about the same amount of cooking. Just that way you have like a very consistent consistency to it, so. Ratchet bitches wanting for she's not Philippe. That's the type that put me in my mood. She know that I'm up and she come cool for me. She know how to put me in my groove. I know it's a lot that you can learn from me. It's just one thing that you gotta prove. If you gotta walk with just a ride for me, I might need an extra foot or two. Gotta keep my distance, they surround me. I'ma need an extra foot or two. They might have to go and build a house for me. I'ma need an extra foot or we didn't do so much around. Alright, so here is the finished product. Creole same size as the Galleria. Spanish model with me, call her senorita. Alright, so here is what the finished product looks like. I put the towel down just to catch any extra grease. Just because I don't really like them when they're too greasy, so I do kind of get that extra oil with the paper towel. And like I said, we are going to be having the other ones, the leftovers, going while I eat. Just that way we have like a second round in case we get hungry. So this is just one of a lot of pre-workout meals that I will typically make. So if you guys do enjoy this type of video where I kind of just take you through what I'm doing, how I'm eating before I lift, let me know in the comments. I have a whole bunch more where this came from. But alright guys, that's going to wrap up today's video. Make sure you subscribe, stay tuned for more videos. If you enjoyed, drop a like. Use code Shaw for any Rise products, you'll get 15% off. And don't forget, my program, if you want to switch up your routine, is available in the description below. It's for $20. We'll be running sales probably for New Year's. So make sure to look out for that. But yeah, see you next video.